Hi everyone, today we are going to see about direct retainers in removable partial denture. Actually, it is a component part of RPD that is used for detaining and preventing the dislodgement consisting of class assembly or precision attachment. Coming to the retention, it is a quality inherent in the processes which resists the force of gravity, adhesiveness of wood and forces associated with opening of jaws. Let's go into the classification. Extracoronal and intracoronal. Extracoronal is divided into manufactured and customized. Intracoronal is internal attachment, external bar attachment, stud attachment and special attachment. Coming to the extracoronal direct retainer, it is also defined as clasp. It is a part of RPD and also acts as a direct retainer for the denture, mainly by partially encircling or contacting the abutment tooth. There are various considerations in clasp. They should be located at the undercut area for determining the path of insertion and removal, and also should be involved in the processes. Here, a main theory is involved, that is Cohn's theory. According to the Cohn's theory, it is shape of crown of premolars and molar should be equivalent to the upper and lower structures common to the bases. Coming to the path of clasp, there are various types, various components. First one is retentive terminal. Second one is retentive clasp arm. Third is reciprocal arm. Fourth is occlusal wrist, that is upper part. And fifth is shoulder, that is both. Sixth is a body which connects all the other components. And the seventh is a minor connector from the other parts. Coming to the retentive arm, it is a flexible part mainly engaged on abutment to retain the denture. Consists of retentive clasp arm and retentive terminal. It also lies below the height of contour. The next one is a reciprocal arm. It is a arm used in opposing the action of other parts of processes. Mainly it provides stability and also acts as indirect retainer to the minimum point. It resists lateral forces and also rocking of denture bases. Coming to the shoulder, it is a part of clasp connects the body to the clasp terminal. It lies above the height of contour and mainly stabilization is involved here. Body, it is the main part which connects the shoulder to the rest of the minor connectors. Tissue surface of body is closely related to guide plane, that is known as proximal plate. It is involved in the direct retainer. Coming to the wrist, it is a rigid extension of RPD which contacts the tooth to dissipate horizontal or vertical forces. The next one is minor connector which connects all the other components to the major connectors such as clasp or indirect retainers. It is a mainly approach arm type. There are various principles and requirements of direct retainers. Coming to the principles, occlusal wrist should be designed to prevent tissue displacement. Retentive terminal should be opposed. Balanced retention is mainly involved here. Path of escapement should never coincide with the path of removal. Primary abutment clasp never exceed the tipping forces. Various requirements are involved here. First one is retention, stability, support, encirclement, reciprocation and passivity. Coming to the types, there are three types. C clasp, that is cast circumferential clasp or acres clasp. The next one is bar clasp. Coming to the cast circumferential clasp, it is a clasp that encircles tooth more than 180 degree and also has a tooth contact with the tooth, with at least one terminal being in the infrabulge area. Advantages are easier to make and retention and support. Disadvantages, it damages soft tissue and also difficult to adjust with pliers. It can't be used in undercut areas. In cast circumferential clasp, there are 11 types of clasp. First one is simple circular clasp. They are used for tooth-supported partial denture, used in undercut areas, can't be used in distal extension cases. The next one is reverse clasp. They are used in retentive undercut, which is located adjacent to the edentulous space, used in distal extension denture bases. Disadvantages, poor aesthetics, wedging will occur. It also affects the strength of the clasp. This is a simple circular clasp, which are located below the tooth, and the reverse circular clasp. Third one is multiple circular clasp. It is a combination of two simple clasp. It is used for sharing mainly retention. Mode of splintering weakened tooth is mainly involved here. The next one is embracer clasp, that is also known as modified grip clasp. This is a combination of two simple clasp joined at the body, used in class 2 and class 3 Kennedy cases with no modifications. The next one is ring clasp. They are used in cases where the reverse circular clasp can't be used. Used in cases with lingually tipped molar abutments. Mainly advantages are additional support. Disadvantages are can't retain physical properties and mainly difficult to repair. The next one is fish hook clasp, that is also known as hairpin clasp or reverse action clasp. It is also a simple circular clasp used in undercut areas with edentulous spaces. Indications are presence of soft tissue undercut. Disadvantages are poor aesthetics and food debris can be get accumulated in the surface so that it is difficult to remove the surfaces tissues. The next one is onlay clasp. It is an extension of metal crown with buckle and lingual clasp palm used in occlusal surfaces. Only caries resistant tooth can be used. The next one is combination clasp. It is has a greater flexibility used in both canines and premolars because of its aesthetic concern. Advantages, they can be flexible in all planes. Disadvantage, easily breaks and poor stability. This is a combination clasp and this is the only clasp. The next one is off and off clasp. It is a retentive arm from one direction and reciprocal arm from other clasp. Two minor connectors are needed here. Dual retention and also mainly for produce to large tooth area coverage. The next one is back action clasp. That is a modification of ring clasp. Disadvantages mainly lack of support. The next one is VRHR clasp. That is vertical, reciprocal, horizontal, retentive clasp. It is also known as Grasso clasp. It consists mainly vertical, reciprocal arm, horizontal, retentive arm, and occlusal rest. The next kind of clasp is bar clasp, that is vertical projection or roach clasp. It is a clasp having a arm that is a bar type extension from major connector to the soft tissue and approaches the area of contact of tooth in gingival occlusal direction. There are various parts in bala, retentive arm and reciprocal arm. Retentive arm only varies from this cast circumferential clasp. It comprises gingival approach arm and retentive tip. Advantages are easy to insert. Aesthetic concern is mainly involved here. Disadvantage, it collects the food debris between the occlusal surfaces, reduces stabilization. There are various types of clasp in the bar clasp, that is roach clasp, modified T-clasp, T-clasp, Y-clasp, I-clasp, infra bulge clasp and I-bar. First we go into the T-clasp, that is it is used in distal extension cases with distal buccal undercut. It mainly has good disadvantage, it can't be used in case terminal abutment tooth. The next one is modified T-clasp. Used in canines and premolar regions. Next, coming to the Y-clasp, it is a modified T-clasp to shoot certain abutments. Here, height of contour is high at the facio-mesial distance and low at facio-distal line angles. Coming to the I-clasp, that is used in distobuccal surface of canine for only aesthetic purpose. Disadvantage is stability is decreased here. The next one is infrabulge, that is also known as mirror view clasp. It arises from the border of the denture base as an extension, mainly made of wrought wire. It also has a flexibility concern. The next one is I-bar, that is a modified I-clasp developed by Kratochvil. It is mainly used to design reduce the tooth contact areas. The next one, intracoronal direct retainers. Actually, we have seen the extracoronal, that is a clasp. There are three types, cast circumferential clasp, bar clasp and combination clasp. Let's go into the intracoronal direct retainers, that is also known as attachment because it is always located within the contour of the abutment tooth. There are various types. First one is internal, second external, stud, bar and special attachments. Coming to the internal attachment, it is also known as precision attachment or frictional attachments. What is internal attachment? It is a retainer used in RPD consistent construction consisting of metal receptacle and also a closely fitting part. Actually, Dr. Herman C.S. Chase first formulated the internal attachment in 1806. Commonly used attachments are Nechase attachment, Stern-Goldsmith attachment, Baker attachment. Advantages of internal attachment are elimination of visible retentive components and visible vertical support. Disadvantages are difficult to repair, complicated lab procedures, and also loss of tooth resistance due to wear procedures, unable for small crowns because of its size. Contraindications are large bulbs and short crowns. The next one is external attachment, that is more aesthetic, resilient, and hard to replace. Mainly indicated for anterior because of its aesthetic concern in young age. Disadvantages are difficult to replace and weak. Example, Dalvorid attachment, Sika attachment, and ERA attachment. The next one is stud attachment. It also acts like a stress director used in overdenture abutment cases. Advantages are easy to repair and versatile. Disadvantages are complex design and expensive. Example, Gerber and Rollerman. The next one is bar attachment. It is used mainly when the bone loss is occurs around the abutment tooth. Advantage is splinting and crossarch stabilization. Disadvantage is mainly space is required and also difficult to maintain oral hygiene. Here comes the last part, that is the special attachment. It also both differs from both intracoronal and extracoronal retainers. Mainly aesthetic concern here, classified into locking and non-locking device and also used in Kennedy class 1 and class 2 cases. Actually, first we saw seen the extracoronal, that is divided into three, cast circumferential, bar clasp and roach clasp. Bar or roach clasp and combination clasp. Coming to the intracoronal, internal attachment, external attachment, stud, bar attachment and special attachments. These are the direct retainers involved in the removal partial denture. Thank you for watching. Keep supporting me always.